It's time for people. So it's more simple words than that pay him. No, what's that one for, sir? I start to study and trying to figure out this thing. Is there a man in this world, if he could have a ruler or a tape measure to measure the distance between the heaven and the earth? What figure you could come up with? To say this is the figure between heaven and earth. It's only God could come up with a figure like that. Yet God's telling me anyway that that is the reference he's using to show us how great his mercy is towards us.
Great mercy,
brother.
Oh yes.
Mercy.
And
mercy
beyond.
All that mercy. Yeah. It's so high.
That's right.
Between the heavens and the earth, and God comparing this towards me and you.
What am I thinking?
Yet when people say things about you, you just let people condemn you. And God's mercy so great towards me, there is enough room for I to change my life.
Yeah.
Follow me now. I want to know. What is that? That is the reason why I want to urge all of you before all of you leave here. You see, God don't just give up on people.
That's right.
And this is the attitude the church need to develop. You don't just give up on people.
Thank you.
Yeah, sir. Follow me now. Follow me now. I'm not saying this because this is my opinion. Let me look at what the Bible says and I go close. What is that? What is that? In Galatians chapter 6, verse 1. Yeah, Paul was telling the Galatians. He said, brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, you which are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness. Here we go, saying, if a man in fault and the fault even visible, try to bring him back to God and restore him. If you don't have nothing good to say, hush your mouth, even though you're guilty.
Yeah.
Hear this, sir. Hear this, sir. Hear this, sir. Okay. In Psalm 37, verse 23 and 24, hear when he was in it, he said, the steps of a good man is ordered by the Lord. Hear this, sir. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast off, for the Lord holding him with him. So in other words, a good man could fall.
Yes.
But when a good man falls, they say God will still be holding him, even though he fall.
Yes.
So here it is that when we hear, I just can't understand the church. When a man or a woman make a mistake, the first thing for you to do is to bow to them.
Thank you.
God still holding them, that's even right. Though they're in the fall.
Yeah. That's right. Thank you. That's right.
In Proverbs chapter 24, verse 16, they say the righteous has fallen seven times. And he just get up again. And he said, so what I was looking at is the same. They were saying in Micah chapter 7, verse 8, the words said, rejoice not against me, O my enemy, when I fall, I will rise again. Though I sit in darkness, God will be a light unto me. So at times when a man falls and you start to pass your mouth on him, you forget God holding him.
Yes.
I just can't understand some of gospel.
Yeah.
We come into church,
so true.
Singing. We praying and we preaching, and I could be there for you. And I see another minister one. Say,
what,
man? Your preacher, your minister, going through blood, sweat, and tears for you, and he going all over. When you're going through your problem, everybody looking for the pastor.
That's right.
And he going all out to be there for you. From the time he make a mistake, church members,
thank you.
Just turn the back on him. You instant and walk out and leave you.
Yeah.
That man was fighting for you
when
he was in your situation.
Yeah.
You calling him when it's late. When he could be, you could sleep, he can't sleep. And from the time the man make a message, you can't stop talking.
Write him off.
Must see.
You went among warriors and by talking to your pastor.
Yes.
But the mercies of your God
just
remain towards you. Even though you fall, God will wrestle with you. Hallelujah. No. What does this leave? Yeah, no.
That's right.
Because why? All of us is subject to making mistakes. Right. All the preaching. You feel like you're making shame.
Yeah. Yeah. Some of them waiting for that. Is it true?
You know? So this is what will be taking place in the life of believers. God just wants us to bear with one another. Yeah. I said, watch me. Watch. Listen, watch. Listen. My strength is yours.
Yeah.
The areas you're strong in, I could be weak.
Yeah. That's right.
Yet I'm preaching just like you.
Yeah. Yeah.
So if I fall in my weakness and defending or whatever, you just don't condemn me because I'm in a situation.
Thank you.
You understand? And watch me. Hear what does be hard. Eh? You understand? Sometimes friends and family, if you make a mistake, will just turn the back on you and leave you.
Yeah,
and you will
right.
be surprised to hear the things that your own partner will say about you.
Thank
just
you.
Because I make a mistake.
Yes.
Only let us forget preachers and not angels, you know?
Yes.
Right.
They have this thing called a body and it is few things.
Yes.
So they could fall short.
Yes. So you see, if a man overtake me in a fall, you reach a spiritual. Restore such a one in the spirit of meekness. In Matthew chapter 18, verse 11, here where Jesus was saying, he said, the Son of Man has come to seek and save that which is lost. Not the one we say, I come for the one who lost. So when you go to Ezekiel, chapter 34, verse 16, understand? God said, watch man, God started to tell Ezekiel, I will seek after that which is lost. And I will go after them who was driven away. And I will bind up those that was brokenhearted. And I will seek after that which is lost. Because sometimes all these areas, one person to be suffering with it. Sometimes one man gone astray and he brokenhearted. Because of your mouth he was driven away.
Wow.
And he need to heal. And he damaged and he destroyed. And it's easy for the churchman and churchwoman to just turn the back on him and leave him in that condition. But God who does see in secret, know the real you. I could ask you how you're going, and you could tell me you're going good with a smile on your face while you're mashed up inside. But I don't know that, so you can hide it. But God does know the real you.
Yes, that's right.
So when you fall in a fault, He just don't turn it back on you and leave you. God does go all out to what? I tell you, Matthew 18, Jesus was telling the disciples and draw represent. He said, why if a man have 100 sheep?
And just one was true.
That man does leave 99 and go and search for that one. And if he finds it, he will rejoice over that one that was lost more than the 99 that did go astray. So careful with all your mouth if a man make
thank
a mistake from your church.
Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
So God look here. So what? So God started to tell Ezekiel, I will go after them. And I go bind them up. Right? And what man? And God started what man? God started outline a plan to Ezekiel, right? Because we're looking at the Moses of God. Right? You understand? You understand? So in verse 23 of Ezekiel 24, 23 and 24, right? God started to tell Israel, Ezekiel. God like to talk to people. He said, I'll go after them and I will set one shepherd over them. And that shepherd I go set over them, he said that shepherd go be David. And hear me? David go be the shepherd, and I the Lord go be the God. And here he said, and here what man he said, David go be a prince among my people. What man? God boasting on a human being. A man who designed for fall, God boasting on the man. Not human, not like me and you now. Yes. So what's they say? So God now start to tell David. And God start to build David. Now follow me now. I really want you to get this. Watch me. In 1 Samuel 16, verse 13, the writer said that David was anointed by Samuel to be king of Israel. In 2 Samuel 2, 4, they say Judah anointed David. And then in 2 Samuel 5, 3, they say Israel anointed David. So David was anointed three times. What is that? So what kind of man God is now? I'm raising up a man who you don't know about, anointed three times, and I depending on him to see about the people.
Yeah.
What is that? So going through the scripture in Acts chapter 13, verse 22, the writer says, here we go to the man said, I have found David, the son of Jesse, a man that is after my own heart, which shall fulfill all my words. Said, God was in on David. And David responded in Psalm 40, verse 8, and said, I delight to do thy will, O my God, for thy laws is within my hand. Watch me. Here they said, while people are talking to you and saying you are good, heaven does be rejoicing over you because God knows what he called you for.
Yeah, that
just because you make a mistake and people quick to condemn you, God rejoicing over you. Because God knows what you are coming this world for.
Right.
If that things that your mother and father don't know, and you as a child, you come to do that and they hand away to do that, then you know. So God,
start to rejoice over David.
So follow me now, I want you to know. Follow me now. So what they say? So the desire David had, David started to see God. And David and God start to develop what they call like a father and son relationship. And here they say, church, according to Brother Gary, in the foundation with the laying following instruction, I want to add this. When you follow the instruction of God, you just be building in God. But there is an enemy who want to make sure that you don't perfect the instruction or no. So when David was building this relationship with God, Satan started to watch David cook here. Because he's developing a relationship out of the ordinary. Now, what's the set? So David started to develop this relationship with God. And yet, here how David used to practice himself. Before David do anything, he used to ask God.
What's supposed to be? If
David have a desire, based on what God said, he will change his mind because he's following God's instruction. So watch me. So God started to train David. And 1 Samuel 13, verse 8, they said after David asked God if he could follow the Amalekites, so he could buy Amalek, right? And God said, they said, right, I said, God answered and said,
Go and pursue,
and thou shalt surely recover that. Yeah. So what they said, he's following God's instruction. What man? So in 2 Samuel 8, verse 6, it said that God and David, God used David in such a way and developing him in such a way that God allowed David enemies to be servant, and all of a sudden David enemies started being before him and listen. When God done with you, I will make the people who hate you bless you.
And David's enemy.
Start to come and look for him. When you feel he's coming for where, they bring in riches for him.
Yes.
Because he was obeying the instruction of God. And God said, mercy.
Yeah.
What's the mercy? Yeah. What's my word? What's my word? I trust my makeup. Don't condemn that man.
That's right. Yes, Lord.
So what's my
minus?
So what's my? So David started to be like, oh, you follow me, go there. So in 2 Samuel chapter 11, from verse 2 and 3, they said that when God started to train David, and when he's supposed to go out and fight one defend, and David get up off his bed.
Yeah.
And David started to walk on the roof, and the writer said, when David look over the balcony, David said, woman, we need to and the good man take a good look at the naked woman.
Watch me.
The man was training, and the man was walking with God, and the man was talking with God, and the man was hearing God's instruction. But when you see Bathsheba naked, naked, he forget
all that.
What's this? So let me go back. So the good man who take the good look. And the good man who God said order in it, Satan put a woman and what man? You know, like when a woman bathing, you and a man watching, you just watching why? And told him. Because she bathing.
And the good man take a
look. Well, without instruction.
Not without instruction.
And when the spiritual man boy see the things you're not supposed to see. It's just like he never see a woman before. And what's there? And what's there? All the time, Anything David had to do, he has seen God there. When David see Bathsheba, he has his
own.
I'm trying to prepare the church to show you, make up your mind. Yeah. If you decide to follow the instruction of God because I was there, make up your mind for a fight to them.
Yes, right. Yes, yes.
All over. Okay.
That's right.
Remember this scripture. Yeah. And David asked after the woman, watch me. The servant come back and tell him, this is the wife, this is the daughter of Elam, the wife of Uriah. He come and tell David this woman married or not. But watch me. Where is the one Satan show him? He's been made in his mind. Yeah. And the anointed man started to meditate on things he had already. And the man who goes on like this step and walking with God, he lied on the cast the breath because what is he? Remain in his mind.
The
reason why I'm going down this road is to make somebody understand it. Careful how you condemn somebody, you know where you go follow.
Ah, that's right. That's right. That's right.
The anointed said, no, oh, you're all over there, the anointed now.
Yeah, that's right.
Or you could preach gospel now.
Yes.
And you could rebuke people now.
Thank you.
But you don't know
where you fall. This is true. This is true.
You and I tell you.
Thank you. Yeah. True, it's true.
And he's studying you.
Yeah.
Watch me. I want to warn the church about something. When Satan attack him, Satan and I attack him against him. He said, listen, somebody to fight you because they study you.
Wow.
Watch me. So follow me now. So I want to point out this now. I want to point out this. Say, no, watch me. God is a God. Look here. God is a God to see in front. And when God has student training to make you and to build you, you understand? God will show you things in front. Yet when David see Bathsheba, God remains silent.
Silent. Yeah.
I ain't going to tell him it's about a woman coming to throw him down.
Wow.
All the faithful, yeah. It's about a woman, he said, I am telling him nothing. Yeah. I'm going to remain
silent.
It's true.
Yeah.
God with me.
Silent.
Because you know what? David stopped asking God question.
Right.
So when God will like remain silent to it. And so what's me? Yeah? So David gone and enjoy what remain on his mind. And I can imagine he closing the eye and had a good time. And when the report come back. Because it was in his mind.
But it's true.
I'm trying to state facts. I'm trying to be out of context. Watch me. So, when that happened, and the comedy appeared, and Bathsheba said to say, boy, I'm pregnant, boy, and yeah, watch me.
They have any trouble, sir. Yeah.
You feel when he was watching the woman, and well, there was trouble. It's when he come in the act.
Wow. Then God starts to speak. Yeah.
Everybody. The anointed man.
Yeah.
The man who anointed 3 times. The man who steps God all in. The man who God boasts on it. Fall in a fall.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Still look on them. Man. Yeah.
And what's this? All this time, God and David not communicating. Because she come and she get pregnant now, right? And what then? And there's still no conversation.
No conversation.
Between God and his students. And God remain
silent.
Lord Jesus. Yeah.
2 Samuel 11, verse 15. When David get the bread, in secret, David write a letter and give the captain. And tell him, he says, set Uriah in the forefront of the hottest battle and retire from him that he may be smitten again because you're only my wife.
Yeah. Mercy Jesus. Mercy Lord.
All this time, and watch me, he gone and did it in secret. But in Proverbs chapter 15, verse 3. They said the eyes of the Lord is in every place, beholding the evil and the good. We can't hide from that, fellow boy.
God.
Yeah.
God,
yeah.
We brother. God, yeah.
God, Jesus.
Now, what he said, I want to show this one.
Mercy,
I want
to show this one.
In verse 11, they share the extension and the mercies of God. So God sent the prophet now to talk to him. And the first thing the prophet do is draw a prince with a man called Abdensi Man Rahawan. And David judged the man and said that he didn't have no mercy in the bed. And he doesn't use him.
Go on, go on, man.
Go
on, man.
Use him, man.
The man.
That's it. And what's man? What's this? What was man? Well, you take your this section, eh? And God started telling him, I want to show you something. Even though God merciful, don't get tired with God merciful.
Thank you. Yeah.
Don't feel you can do anything you want, and God could be blinded by His love for you. Or
yes,
not.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Tell us.
Okay.
Yeah.
God tell him. In verse, in chapter 11, verse 9 to 12, he said, "Wherefore hast thou despised the commandments of God, of the Lord, to do evil in it?" I hear God telling them, eh? "Thou hast taken wife of you, of you, and he died, and I've killed him with the sword." And here, where God said, here God said, you see that sword you use? Lord, that I go leave your house.
Of. Lord have mercy.
God, yes.
What a time.
Yeah.
Walk with me. Yes. In Job chapter 1, when Satan and God was carrying on the conversation, man. In verse 10, when Satan tells God, "Has not God made a hedge about his house?"
Yeah.
And know that he have. So what is it? God discovered the household of his people.
Yeah.
And when the head like us is about the keeping she and thanksgiving, but she had to be walking spot on with God or not?
Yes.
To keep the hedge.
Yes. Yes. Only family.
Any reason why I bring up that, eh? So God tell David in verse 11, here God say, hey, here God say, "I will take your wives from before your eyes, and I will give them to the neighbor."
Wow.
Yeah, he say, "I will raise up evil against you." He say, "You know why? Because you did it in secret."
Wow.
"I will not do this in the open."
Wow.
Watch, man. God's beloved that he bringing up and he use and he training to think he and people, he going easy on him.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
It is to teach you and me something. Even though God loves us and Jesus and we're depending, no way doing it.
That's right. Yeah, we are.
What is that? Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. What's man? As a man, what's man? It's a serious thing. God come and tell you, "I go take your wife from him."
Yeah. Yeah.
Long ago, Israel was judged by the old law. An eye for eye or a tooth for a tooth. If you kill a man, you have to be killed. If you take a man's wife, they go take yours.
Yeah, yes.
Oh Lord.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. And here it is that the righteous man of God fall in a fault. And God, what man? God speak against David also.
Yeah.
And anytime they move the head, Satan just walk in. And Satan could come in your house based on what you hiding and doing in secret and attack you through your children.
Mercy, yeah. Lord.
Some preachers want to know why the children so hard.
Yeah.
And why this going on and the house in chaos and defend. Is it because of what them doing in secret?
Lord Jesus.
Some of our leaders would hide and have affairs and all these things, and they don't understand when you do that, the sin falls back on your heart.
That's right, that's right.
Because Satan will never go to move the hedge.
That's right.
In your house. And you wondering why you're troubling with children in that trouble, you have to check yourself.
Oh Jesus.
As the head of you. So the man of God fall in a fault. And when he fall in a fault here, when you do so and you watch it, he before God and he guilty.
Yeah.
Watch it. David failed the test miserably. But the mercies of God
have to pray like that, man.
Yeah.
Have to pray like that and pray.
So the guilty man Come before God with a snared conscience and open me mouth in prayer.
Right.
And hear what God said, and hear what God said, and they record David praying Psalm 51.
Right. Have mercy upon me, O God. Yeah, according to thy loving kindness.
And the guilty man open me mouth and say, have mercy upon me, O God. The man starts to pray, and when you talk evil, man, in verse 10 of Psalms, if you want to say,
me, a clean heart. Yes. Are you the right
spirit?
Yes.
So, you pray, man. In verse 12, he said, restore.
Unto me,
unto me the joy of thy salvation. He said, and uphold me with your fist, brother. You know what he's saying, man? While you're restoring, man, I will hold him.
Yeah.
David start to ask God because of the guilt for a total makeover from inside. Yes. Yeah. And he tell him, God, I want you to create in me. I want you to renew, and I want you to restore in me, then I will teach.
Oh, Jesus. Get on thy ways. Yes.
Because when he renew me, and I am teaching according to my knowledge, the old man, I'm teaching under the influence of your spirit.
Oh, yes.
Because it's only the spirit of God could bring man from darkness to light.
Who could make a clean thing?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Last but not least. Get this, eh? When David prayed that prayer, it reminded God of a old promise.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. That he made it. Yeah.
And hear the promise. Hear the promise, eh? In Ezekiel 36, from verse 24 to 27, God was telling Israel when he drove them away. He said, I will gather you from all countries, and I will bring you back to your old land. And here he said, and then I will sprinkle clean water on you, and you will be clean from your fornication and your idols. He said, then I will stick away. Then I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you. But the spirit that we're talking about is the spirit of your mind. Because in Ephesians 4:22 said, be renewed in the spirit of your mind. And in verse 27, he turned around and said, then I will put my spirit in you.
Yes.
What's it say? So when David, coming back now as a renewed man. He's coming back to teach him, and what, man? David would have had a strength on him if he didn't fall.
Oh, yeah.
But that's something when you fall in a fall, it is be of God.
Mercy, Lord.
It has been designed to build you. It has been designed to strengthen you. And when you make a mistake, that's when you teach it, you teach off your own mistake.
Yeah.
You teach from the heart.
Right.
The reason why we just make mistakes. But when we make mistakes, people will be quick to give up on us.
Yeah.
But it has happened for good. Let me show you something. When Jesus was carrying the cross, look here, he had to carry it for a time.
Lord,
but that's the same thing that happened to him. The same thing that happened to Simeon. You had to throw it on your shoulder for some miles until they meet Siren of Cyrene. So at time when you go through a bad situation, God wants to use that same situation to kill the old you.
Right. Oh, yeah.
So when I bring you back, you're coming back renewed. Don't worry if people give up on you. And your brother and your sister turn against you, and husband leave, and wife leave. God will never, look here, he promised never to leave us.
Not forsake us.
But to be with us, to go with us to the end. That is why his mercy is so great. So watch me. So God forgave David through his mercy.
Oh, yeah.
So you can't be with somebody.
Oh, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Grant us the grace.
Yeah, brother, sister, because I want another. So you can forgive someone.
Woo!
You're telling me you're following Jesus?
Yeah.
That's right.
There's an example Jesus lead. Well, if you want to follow me and do anything, you can be with somebody.
Right.
If somebody follows
you,
yeah. It's someone's fault.
Yes.
I'm not taking away from what Pastor Colin said that people are going to want you like, oh, that's good.
whatever the mercies of God is towards you, you can show somebody else mercy?
Yeah, understand. Right.
You don't know who I don't have me a cup of water when I get sick.
True, true.
Sometimes you want sharing this food to just forsake you.
Yes.
A stranger is not going to cup of water.
That's right, that's right.
A stranger is not going to cross your food to your women. Sometimes you know what we are going to do with yes. And the same enemy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have to come and clean you and wash you.
When they come to see about you, you have to put your head on the ground because you're getting used to
that. That's right. Yeah. Yeah.
You're shaved.
Yeah.
Thank God tonight for His mercy. I just want to encourage you. In Jesus' name, there is no city on earth for me to dwell. Come on,
there is no city on earth for me to dwell. But there is a city where love I under. There is no city on earth for me to dwell. There is no city on earth for me to dwell.
There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell. There is a city on earth for me to dwell.
Jesus.